80 and you take off the show. Congratulations. Well done. Yeah. Terrific, Michelle, and we'll see you on the next final. My encouragement award, which is the... And you are, of course, richer by $3,000 for the compliments of Westpac. My encouragement award, it really was very hard tonight. So many people I could have given it to. I chose the very first act, Sarah Fraser. Congratulations to Sarah. That's our show for this evening. Thank you, Ronnie. Thank you, Karen. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful week. Good night, everybody, and see you Monday morning at 9 o'clock for Good Morning Australia.
Stay on 10 for part two of National Geographic's Lost Fleet of Guadalcanal, coming up next. Dame Kiri Kanawa is acknowledged as one of the world's leading sopranos. Her concerts around the world are sellouts. And tonight at 9.30, you can experience a special musical treat. Dame Kiri in concert, 9.30 tonight on 10.
Has been a Disney Entertainment production for Network 10. Tonight at 6.30, part two of 10's documentary of the week, The Lost Fleet of Guadalcanal. At 7.30, a special two-hour Murder, She Wrote. And at 9.30, a night of musical magic, Dame Kiri Kanawa in concert.
Documentary of the week. Tonight, National Geographic and Robert Ballard continue to share the secrets of the lost fleet of Guadalcanal.
In the beginning, Guadalcanal was simply an obscure island in the Southwest Pacific. By the end, it was known as the Island of Death. A world war descended upon the Pacific in December 1941 when Japanese bombers raided the U.S. base at Pearl Harbor. By the summer of 1942, scores of ships carrying thousands of Marines were steaming westward to stop the Japanese advance. In July, intelligence radioed an urgent message. The Japanese were building an airstrip on Guadalcanal. A Marine task force set out to take that airstrip. 11,000 Marines waded ashore, carving out a small beachhead. For months, in bloody battles on both land and sea, the Japanese attempted to recapture the vital airstrip. Allied forces turned them back, but their lack of supplies soon became agonizing. By October, the Marines seemed to be sliding toward ruin. For 50 years, the Battle of Guadalcanal lived on only in memory. And then, in 1992, oceanographer Bob Ballard came to the South Pacific to explore Iron Bottom Sound, the vast graveyard of 50 ships, all sunk in the pivotal battle of the Pacific War. In his first 10 days at Guadalcanal, Ballard had filmed several of the lost ships he was after. With a week left to go, he began to search for the powerful battleship Kirishima, the largest ship in Iron Bottom Sound.
Kirishima is the ship we want the most, but it's going to be tough. All we have to go on is where the Japanese admiral said it went down, but we've been in Guadalcanal for weeks now, and none of the ships have been in the admiral's positions.
We're getting close to the admiral's position.
Well, there's nothing there. Nothing. Mud. Lots of mud.
Searching for ships with sonar is a very frustrating business. It can fool you. You can go by a rock formation, a geologic feature, and think it's a ship when it really isn't.
More geology.
More geology.
More geology.
Yeah, we got something. Probably more geology.
Something.
That's it.
Well, but it's got to be
look
a
at it.
Big
keeps
something.
Going. Look at that.
What's its length?
150
it?
Meters.
Thicker than
it's
a destroyer.
Still going, man.
It's growing. It's big.
170 meters.
170 meters.
170 meters.
That's it.
All right. We got it.
All right,
we
tell,
got it.
Go tell people we got it.
We got it?
We, yep,
got,
we got it.
Look at it. Oh, my God. How about
now let's dive on it.
The Ballard's elation was short-lived. The battery of the submarine Sea Cliff failed to take a charge. At the same time, the power supply of the robotic vessel Scorpio burned itself out. The expedition had suddenly hit the wall.
This is the worst part of the expedition. We have 14 ships identified and the submarine's broken. Scorpio's also broken, so we can't get any of our assets down, and we've got less than a week to go.
Pilot deck suit. Pia, test latches.
Well, this transformer's shot.
You don't have another one?
No, we don't have any spares on board.
Now, let's take a look at it.
All right.
God, that's cremated. Got some of this back at home?
Yeah, we've got a spare back in the other vehicle that we can cannibalize and bring that out here, but it could be anywhere from 1 to 3 days before we get a flight in.
Forget it.
Okay, this is serious stuff. We just find the battleship and now we can't film it.
Right.
It's never easy and there's always a problem. The part is on another submarine out at sea right now. It has to come into San Diego. Drop the batteries out of that submarine, steal the parts, jump on an airplane, fly halfway around the world to get the parts here. It's maddening.
Fifty years earlier, the Marines on Guadalcanal faced impending disaster. They controlled only a shallow arc of land on a large island. The Japanese ruled the sea, cutting off Allied supplies. But the Americans had one trump card, the pockmarked rutted track called Henderson Field. Whoever held Henderson Field held the key to victory. The airfield was called an unsinkable aircraft carrier. Until the night, and Admiral Yamamoto's battleships tried to sink it.
On the island, on October 12th, was my birthday. I had now reached the advanced age, through a lot of good luck, to be 19 years old. And lo and behold, about 1 a.m. on the 13th, these tremendous blasts all of a sudden occurred, seemingly to us out of nowhere.
Boom, boom, boom. And a big flash of light rose up out of the Iron Bottom Sound against those low-hanging clouds, and a staccato pounded against those banks.
And this went on, louder, like freight trains whizzing over your head. And I thought, Jesus, I'll never live to see my 19th year. Hell of a time. I only have one day at being 19.
General Vandegrift wrote, "Until someone has experienced shelling, he cannot easily grasp the sensation of helplessness, fear, and shock. A man comes close to himself at such times." The next morning, the Marines crawled out of their foxholes to find Henderson Field a wreck, their radio station destroyed, most of their plane fuel blown up. A hit on a ration dump had spangled the landscape with shards of spam. Most of the American planes were either damaged or destroyed.
They fired 973 14-inch shells at us that night, and they tore that airfield up, they tore our airplanes up, they tore everything up.
Tonight, the setup for the perfect murder.
Someone wanted me dead.
A trusted friend turned deadly enemy.
It was poison.
Poison?
2 hours of intrigue with television's most loved super sleuth. Murder, She Wrote, tonight on 10.
You can really taste the flavors in Masterfood's authentic salsa and creamy new dips. Try some at your next party.
That's good.
For a bit of a change. Master Foods, the taste master.
House and land sell out this weekend. No reasonable offer will be refused. There are 21 quality 3, 4, and 5 bedroom homes that must be sold this weekend. All house and land packages include these extras. Make us an offer. You may miss out on the bargain of a lifetime. Visit Henley Properties Display Centre this weekend and see our ad in the Herald Sun Homes and Land section.
Henley Properties, a tradition of quality.
The Melbourne Guide to Good Thai Restaurants, Sawadee in the city. Sawadee means welcome. Spacious cocktail lounge and traditional Thai cuisine, Sawadee. Song Klar at Doncaster. The decor and elegant surrounds is a popular choice for exotic cuisine and friendly service, Song Klar. Koh Samui in Middle Park. Personal service, subtle tangy flavours and distinctive decor, Koh Samui. For the best in Thai food, friendliness and service, Sawadee, Song Klar, Koh Samui.
Gorgeous hair is the best revenge.
Ultras is for women who demand the best.
This is for my mother, who said, "Angela, can't you do anything better with your hair?" This is for Phil, for thinking Nancy was better.
Ultras has a unique gel for the ultimate in color, shine, and condition.
This is for me, a redder, better me.
This is for you, honey.
You thought you'd be better off with a brunette?
Ultras from Clairol. Gorgeous hair is the best revenge.
Lisa, I want some more.
More?
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 Lisa, potatoes and more.
New potatoes and more from Maggi makes choice Tasmanian potatoes more tasty, more cheesy. In no more than 10 minutes, you couldn't ask for more.
Ask for more?
New Maggi potatoes and more. They'll be back for more.
With American planes disabled, the Japanese were free to land troops for a new offensive. The next day, the Marines woke to a humiliating spectacle. A huge task force calmly unloading soldiers in plain view of the Americans.
The Japanese are landing men, equipment, artillery, of which we could do nothing about. We were powerless at this point. And we were given gunny sacks, which we were told had the last of the rations you're going to be issued and the last of the ammunition. It wasn't too good a future at that point.
The Japanese army soon launched its offensive, sideways. Their plan was complex. to march all the way around the Marines and attack from behind. On October 16th, the Sendai Division began their march. They ended up chopping trails through a trackless jungle, completely losing some units and exhausting the rest. After 3 days, they sharpened bayonets, expecting to fight the next morning, but couldn't find the enemy for 5 more days. Finally, on October 24th, at least some of the Japanese force attacked the ridge just south of Henderson Field. The Japanese outnumbered the Marines by 3-1. But they charged straight at fortified positions. These dubious tactics seemed to work. After days of furious fighting, the Japanese took the crest of a ridge west of the airfield. On October 25th, they radioed, "Banzai, right wing captured airfield." The report was premature. Marine artillery blasted the Japanese off the ridge. The Americans surged forward, and the battle was over. 2,200 Japanese lost their lives. American deaths numbered just 84. For the Japanese Army, the aftermath of the battle for Henderson Field was as bad as the bloodbath itself. The Sendai Division had to retreat the way it had come, through 30 miles of swamp and jungle. This time, it would be without food. One officer wrote in his diary,
"October 27th. We haven't eaten for 3 days. I have to rest every 2 meters. October 29th. I don't know how many men must be left behind today."
The soldiers abandoned their equipment. They started to eat leaves, bark, roots. The entire Japanese force was starving. They began to call Guadalcanal the Island of Death. Roy Wihata, a second-generation Japanese-American, was assigned to military intelligence. Over 20 years before, his parents left Japan with a dream. They came to America to find a better life. After Pearl Harbor, they lost their farm. They lost everything but an album of photos. Roy's family was sent to an internment camp in Arizona, while Roy was in Guadalcanal fighting for his country.
I thought that I was doing the correct thing at all times, and there was no hesitation on my part to even fire at any Japanese soldier if they're on the other side of the front line.
On Guadalcanal, Wihata volunteered to interrogate Japanese prisoners.
The Japanese commanders never expected their soldiers to surrender. They hadn't even told their soldiers not to talk. So it was very easy to get information from the prisoners. The early prisoners were bleeding in their mouth, and I asked them, "Why? How come you have injuries around your mouth?" He said, "The Marines used to use their rifle butt to take out all these gold teeth that they were had in their mouth." So this is how I found out they were treated poorly by some of the Marine soldiers.
We took some prisoners, and a guard was placed on them. In the middle of the night, he shot them. Why? He got tired of standing watch, so he shot them. We knew that they didn't try to escape. They couldn't. So, and in this type of savagery, one reverts to an almost barbaric everyday type of existence, and you do things under these conditions that nobody in their right mind or normally would do. They probably, and us, but we did them.
From the State Theatre, Melbourne, one of the world's leading sopranos presents a selection of the world's finest music, featuring grand arias and popular songs. 9:30 tonight on 10, Nissan Infinity proudly presents Dame Kiri to Kanawa in concert.
Seem so relaxed. Easy. Easy Music 3MP 1377 and now also on 693.
You can really taste the flavours in Masterfood's authentic salsa and creamy new dips. Try some at your next party.
Mm, that's good.
For a bit of a change. Master Foods, the taste master.
Hey, it's Uncle Toby's 100-year celebration and they're giving you the presents. There's 500,000 free Jimmy Barnes CD singles only to be found in selected Uncle Toby's celebration packs. Plus, there's 15 rock stickers to collect. Flip yours over and you could instantly win one of 5 Family World Holidays trips to LA, 20 Sanyo CD players, 5,000 Australian Celebration CDs, and $5 discount vouchers from Brash's. Every Uncle Toby's Celebration pack wins. Plus, call this 0055 number for more details and you could win a world holidays trip for two to Pattaya, staying at the Royal Cliff Resort. Uncle Toby's, serving up Australia's best prize giveaway in 100 years.
Now Sunbeam shows you how to turn last night's mince into magical savoury mince pies. Or leftover chicken into magical chicken and mushroom pies. New from Sunbeam, it's pie magic. Just think them up, you choose from a can or the fridge, fill them up, and 8 minutes later, two golden brown crispy pies. Tonight, it's fresh fruit pies. Sunbeam's new pie magic. Think them up, fill them up, bake them up. It's just magic.
Is popping down to the corner shop for an orange. New Orange Lucozade.
Doogie's stressed out. Vinny's blocked out.
What must it be like to be you?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
But there's one way to relieve the tension.
Roll!
A Flight of Fancy. Doogie Howser, Sunday on 10.
After nearly a week of waiting, and with only 4 days left in Guadalcanal, the expedition's submarines were finally functional. Ballard prepared to dive just before dawn.
Surface control, this is Seacliff Delta 2.5, over.
As we dive, we try to occupy ourselves with our equipment. Checking our sensors.
4, 5, 6, descent radius.
Making sure we're on course.
No target on the sonar.
But what you're really thinking about is what we're going to see when we finally get down there.
But as Seacliff neared the ocean bottom, Ballard suddenly noticed something very disturbing on his carbon dioxide indicator.
CO2 is going up. Yep, it's going up.
As the CO2 level rose, oxygen was disappearing. Breathing would soon become impossible.
Seacliff control.
The Seacliff was 3,000 feet deep. The ascent back to the surface would take over an hour.
MMHG.
A backup meter confirmed the danger.
Control C clip. CO2 continues to rise. Request permission to terminate. Over.
Fighting panic, the men were soon forced to use an emergency oxygen supply.
Control C clip, donning EBS, over. Expedite.
With one oxygen mask out of commission, the three divers had to share two masks. With agonizing slowness, the sea cliff rose toward the surface.
We came here to document the war, to document the insanity that took so many lives. But the last thing I expected was to join the men who died in Iron Bottom Sound. I'm glad we survived this one.
Interesting dive.
In November 1942, the majestic battleship Kirishima led a powerful fleet of 61 ships toward Guadalcanal. With the fleet went the Empire's final hopes to recapture the island. Their plan called for the fleet to bombard Henderson Field. 11 troop transports would then land 7,000 fresh soldiers on the island. The Japanese command wrote, "The coming naval battle is the fork in the road which leads to victory, for them or for us." An innovation called radar gave the Allies the advantage of surprise, in theory. But the American commander did not trust the newfangled instrument. He knew where the Japanese ships were, but he didn't fire. He didn't fire for 8 long minutes. Ships that could hit targets 12 miles away came within 5 miles, then 2 miles, then 1, and then less.
Suddenly, I could see a line of American cruisers directly in front of us. So we snapped on our searchlights.
Bingo, came a searchlight right on the Atlanta. I could still see that light off the port bow, burning a hole right through me. It was just amazing. At that point, I saw the forward guns of the Atlanta swing out so rapidly and fire.
In minutes, 13 American and 14 Japanese ships were all firing, almost at random. The two formations dissolved into chaos. Opposing ships came so close that sailors shot at each other with machine guns. Murdoch's Atlanta was smashed by 2 full battery salvos from another American ship. On Bert Doughty's Munson, the captain thought he was being fired on by friendly ships. He switched on recognition lights, and the destroyer was immediately struck by 37 shells.
It was just
one hell of a bang, and that was it. I got hit, and I just went out. I lay there unconscious all night long. I didn't get off the ship.
Only a few miles away, Stuart Murdoch was trapped on the bridge of the Atlanta. Shells kept exploding all around him. Murdoch, in panic, vaulted over the bridge rail, a 20-foot drop to the deck.
Down I went. And I hit, I'm pretty certain, a bunch of dead bodies on that gun emplacement, because I heard the noise of their, you know, their lungs, whatever, if it's a shattering kind of feeling right that moment that I'd done that.
At dawn, seven damaged ships still drifted, burning and smoking on the glassy surface of Iron Bottom Sound. One of them was the Monson, where Bert Doughty was still unconscious, pieces of shrapnel lodged in his skull, and his ship sinking beneath him. His help came in the end from sharks. Three of Doughty's friends made it off the ship, but the sharks were so terrifying, they finally paddled back to the sinking destroyer.
They happened to see somebody move. It was me. And they said, well, for crying out, it's Buddy Burt. They called me Buddy Burt. And I was alive.
While Doughty's buddies got him off the ship, Japanese survivors floated on the surface of Iron Bottom Sound. One of them was Mishiharu Shinya.
Many hours passed and the sea and sky gradually became light. Looking toward the east, I saw a small American boat coming slowly toward me. They tried to rescue me, but I blurted out in English, no thanks. Still, you're not really free when you're treading water in the ocean, so eventually I gave up. For us, being captured was extremely shameful, much worse than dying.
By afternoon, boats ferried the wounded Americans, including Stuart Murdoch, to land.
I remember being with the others there, and there was one seaman on a stretcher right by me. Very seriously wounded, you can tell. And I looked at him, he looked at me, and he gave me a smile. That was it. I haven't told this before. And I'll always remember that smile.
Both sides, the battle was incredibly costly. The Americans lost two cruisers, seven destroyers, and over 1,700 men. The Imperial Navy, two battleships, one cruiser, three destroyers, and nearly 1,900 men. A standoff. But the next day, that standoff turned into a decisive American victory. Bombers sank seven Japanese troop transports, ending the Japanese attempt to reinforce, ending Japanese hopes to retake the island, ending any true possibility of the Japanese holding the South Pacific.
When modern-day pirates strike, the lieutenant wants in on the action.
I could use one of his yachts and set up a sting.
But just how close...
How are you enjoying your honeymoon so far?
...will she get? Baywatch, 6:30 Sunday on 10.
I love you. Let me tell you how.
want you. I'm telling you now.
Once you've got the taste for a delicious Wendy's hot dog, when you I'm may never be the same again.
To you, I'm never
Wendy's.
Because I love you.
How come some people always seem so relaxed? Easy. Easy Music, 3MP, 1377, and now also on 693.
Now Sunbeam shows you how to turn last night's mince into magical savoury mince pies. New from Sunbeam, it's Pie Magic. Two golden brown crispy pies every time. Sunbeam Pie Magic. Think them up, fill them up, bake them up. It's just magic.
I'm living all my lifetimes right here, right now. Oh yeah, I wish time gives me time to be with you. I know what I have to do, 'cause part of me is part of you. I feel better now.
Ever played basketball without any air in the ball?
It doesn't bounce.
Right. And that's how you could feel in the morning if you don't have your breakfast. You can lose your bounce and start feeling flat and droopy. Each morning, fill up on a complete breakfast of cereal, milk, toast, fruit, and juice. Because if you start the day with a nutritious breakfast, you're giving it your best shot.
This breakfast message was brought to you by Kellogg's in the interest of good health and nutrition.
They're so irresistible at this age, but remember, they grow up. They'll need good food and education, a trip to the family doctor, which could become expensive. They may even be a problem child. They may have nasty habits. They may even tend to stray. And they'll need to get on with your family. So remember, they won't be babies forever.
They're taking a couple of days off, leaving Beverly Hills behind, and taking on the wilderness.
Are we having fun yet?
It's going to be a wild weekend.
Remember, guys, we're on vacation.
90210, 7:30 Sunday on 10.
Fifty years after the decisive battle, men who had fought each other met again on the Laney Choest.
Were you the first Japanese ship to open searchlights?
Yes, I think so.
I think it was on us. I think. If you were the first.
So you... But I think you are hit by some cruiser.
The first searchlight that came from the Japanese was on the Atlanta. So we immediately swung our turrets off to the port left and started firing, and I'm sure other ships did the same thing.
With 3 days to go in the expedition, Ballard's crew lowered the Scorpio. The two veterans watched from the Laney Choest, hoping for the chance to get a glimpse of their old ships.
Boom into the attached float position.
Boom in.
Oh, there it goes, huh?
There it is. There it is.
There it is.
Drive on back
in. Well, that was startling, wasn't it?
Well, that just comes right on you. There's your ship. Boom.
There, look at the
tremendous damage.
Boy, that torpedo. Yeah. That damn thing set the ship just right up.
So ragged.
So ragged and spread out.
You recognize anything?
Back up. Back up and
up. Control
feet. Do that front up back. Keep it big.
Boy.
And just come up. You want to get above that mess.
Nope, afraid not.
It's pretty messed up.
Keep going back in.
The ship floated on the spot where the two men had fought. reviving their memories of war.
In a war, you don't think personal. You think there's something out there, and you don't care what it is, and you just shoot, and you don't think about what's happening, do you? Yeah.
Because at the time, I was still a young man.
Right, so me too.
I cannot
I couldn't look too far either, huh? Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, maybe he's a raid, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ballard and Shinya reviewed video images of a destroyer they hoped was Shinya's Akatsuki. But identification proved to be a bewildering puzzle. The destroyers Akatsuki and Ayanami were virtually identical.
So this is on the stern?
And both ships had been sunk in the same battle. One of the few distinguishing features had been the name of the ship painted on the hull.
That's an A.
The only remaining Japanese character was the first one, and both Akatsuki and Ayanami began with the same character.
But both ships had the same?
That's right.
Both ships had the same letter.
For Ballard and Shinya, the identity of the wreck would remain a frustrating riddle.
I've come to think that the spectacle of human beings killing each other is without equal. The devil in us makes us enjoy watching it, but no one can make us enjoy having it done to us.
I kept saying I was on borrowed time. Really, it's a feeling that I have a legacy. I just have a feeling, am I a worthy survivor? How can I live my life so that it's worthy of what happened?
And Gary Busey.
Not with personal.
Predator 2, 8:30 Sunday on 10.
Hi, Dewey. I just discovered something you didn't tell me about Nappy San. Of course, all my whites now come up so white and bright. But I'm amazed how well it works on all kinds of things. The kids' sports gear, beach clothes. No, they're not white. Colours. Yes, colours. Oh, Julie, didn't you know?
Nappy San has always been wonderful on whites. The news is it's brilliant on washable colours too.
I know exactly the car I want. I'm really looking at a little hatchback, something.
Now the National introduces the tailored personal loan to help you own that car sooner and save you money.
For me, it'd be being independent as well.
And so we can tailor that loan specifically to suit your needs.
I really didn't think that a personal loan would be so flexible and quick.
And look how much interest you'd save.
Yeah.
So how would you feel about owning your car so soon?
Wonderful.
Ask the National to tailor a personal loan to your needs.
Tastes great. What kind of hamburger is this?
Spamburger.
I see. If you cut it this way, you get 3/4-pound burgers. Hey, that's a good deal.
Spamburger.
Spam is made with ham, right? So really, this is a hamburger. Just buy traditional Spam spiced ham or a new Spam light and you've got the
Spamburger.
It's a great tasting hamburger.
Beautiful sunny day, 35 degrees.
Cloud moving in today, it looks like some rain. Okay.
In a country as unpredictable as Australia, your family deserves all the protection you can give them. The powerful Australian designed and built Mitsubishi Barada V6 wagon.
We all know the delight of sharing. Everyone enjoys a treat now and then. But for many, Biscuits are the essence of life itself. Will you be there when tiny hands reach out for life? Hundreds of thousands of lives have been saved with high-protein biscuits through Care Australia. Many more lives depend on what you give today for World Food Day. Make your donation at any branch of the Commonwealth Bank.
Jobs in the year 2000. Will your children stand a chance?
The shape of work is changing.
The disappearing jobs, those that'll survive.
What people are getting are mixed or confusing messages.
An important guide, first at five.
In the days after the November naval battle, the American fleet limped south for repairs. Mary Clyde Wendell began to hope that her husband Jack would soon get shore leave in San Francisco.
Darling, the day will soon be here when I'll be able to come back home for quite a spell.
By mid-November, Mary Clyde was waiting expectantly for news.
When that Western Union fella came up on the doorstep, I thought it was my cue to come to San Francisco. And when I got went to the door, the man said, "Lady, this is a death message." "We regret to inform you that your husband, Lieutenant Commander Jack Wendell, was killed in action and buried at sea." I thought that he would be untouchable. He was good. That nothing would happen to him. But, you know, you mature, you grow up. You realize that life's not that way.
Weeks after his death, Jack's letters kept coming.
"Darling, the moon has been beautiful of late. Hope you've seen it. I've looked at it and longed for you. Think of you all day and until I fall asleep. Then I dream of you. Wish I could call you on the telephone tonight just to tell you how much I love you."
Mary Clyde Wendell never remarried.
Seacliff control on the bottom, depth 3055. Can you give us a range and bearing to the target? Over.
Only 36 hours before the end of the expedition, Bob Ballard tried one last time to explore the Kirijima.
One more degree, we drive forward.
Finally, he was within yards of the elusive battleship.
In the days when it was just built, the Kirijima was the pride and joy of the Japanese fleet. And for 20 years, when people thought of the Imperial Navy, it's her they thought of. Now, she's come to this.
Oh my God, look at that. This one's upside down. 800 feet of upside down battleship. Amazing. I've never seen a ship in the deep sea upside down. They always right themselves. Bismarck righted itself. Titanic righted itself. Normally they roll back coming on the way down. But this one didn't roll. It must have been that superstructure, you know, it could have acted like a keel. Oh, wow, look at that. It's coming right in by the window. Back off. Boy, look at the size of that propeller. 15, 20 feet across. Oh, watch out, we're getting a little too close.
Look at, is it coming in your window? It looks like we're just about to brush against it. Wow, look at the size of those propellers. Unbelievable.
Kirishima was the last Japanese ship to sink in the November naval battle. And when she went down, the hopes of an entire country went down with her.
After 4 months of fighting, the Americans had a stranglehold on the island. The Marines turned over their hard-won territory to the Army. The Marines bore little resemblance to the fresh young men who had waded ashore. Their uniforms were in tatters, the men themselves sick, exhausted, worn out.
The shock of that leaving Guadalcanal numbed us, and there was no jumping or joy, nobody with any hilarity. I couldn't believe that reaction when I looked back on it, and we just shuffled to load into the Higgins boat and leave this place.
As bad as conditions were for the Americans, they were worse for the Japanese. Without food or reinforcements, the remaining soldiers seemed doomed to die on the island. But on three February nights, the Japanese Navy slipped through the curtain of Allied surveillance to steal 11,000 troops away from their fate. The last act of the campaign, like so much before it, was a mix of courage, blunder, and simple luck.
When we were pulling out from Guadalcanal, we left a soldier there who was still breathing. I will never forget that. The image of that young soldier just being left there, unconscious but still breathing, that keeps coming back to my mind, even today.
For the Marines, after months on the front lines, the next stop was Melbourne. The Australians, Marines agreed, were suitably grateful.
You know, the people of Australia were marvelous. Marvelous. Everybody had an adopted family, it seemed, and certainly had girlfriends. Melbourne was the piece of cake, particularly the parade in front of all those Aussies like that. People were shouting, "God bless you, Yank, you saved Australia." Old ladies would come around, hug you about the neck. Old soldiers from World War I would shake your hand. It brought it all home. The work we had done was not in vain. And it was appreciated.
In a few months, the name Guadalcanal had gone from obscurity to legend. The campaign turned the war around in a literal sense. Before Guadalcanal, the Japanese always advanced. After Guadalcanal, they were always in retreat. The road now led only one way, toward Japan. On August 15th, 1945, Emperor Hirohito broadcast news of Japan's surrender. Japanese soldiers returned home to desolation and even shame.
After the war, we were supposed to stop wearing the military uniform, but we had no other clothes, so we just ripped off the insignia and kept wearing the uniform. As long as I was wearing it, I still felt I was a soldier. But there was nothing much to do there. I spent every day in an absent-minded state. From August, when the war ended, until February, I didn't do any work. I just stayed at home.
How will Brad feel?
I don't care, he's worth it.
When he finds out the truth.
Does Brad know you're only 14?
And a mix-up for Julie.
Mrs. Mel, your test is positive. You're definitely pregnant. Congratulations.
Neighbours, 6:30 Monday on 10.
If there's one thing Target have learnt about kids, it's that you can't stop them being kids. All we can do is make our clothes tougher than the kids. So no matter what your kids do to them, Target Quality Control guarantees they'll live to fight another day. Target's kids' clothes. No matter how tough your kids are, wear tougher.
In Asia, we have a lot of traditions, like cooking satay. That's why Red Rooster have combined the skin-free chicken with the traditional taste of satay.
Red Rooster's delicious skin-free chicken is gently grilled with an authentic satay sauce.
So, if you're ready for a real taste of satay, come into Red Rooster.
Red, red, ready, Red Rooster.
I'm living all my lifetimes, right here, right now. Oh yeah, I wish time gives me time to be with you. I know what I have to do, 'cause part of me is part of you. I feel better.
Macadamia nuts throughout, creamy caramel ice cream, and a crisper cone. Why would you want anything else? New macadamia nut drumstick. When it's this good, it's Peter's.
Hi, Julie. I just discovered something you didn't tell me about Nappy San. Of course, all my whites now come up so white and bright. But I'm amazed how well it works on all kinds of things. The kids' sports gear, beach clothes. Hmm? No, they're not white. Colours. Yes, colours. Oh, Julie, didn't you know?
Nappy San has always been wonderful on whites. The news is it's brilliant on washable colours too.
Hold this position. I'm coming in on the bow.
In his Guadalcanal expedition, Bob Ballard had located 14 ships and filmed 12 of them.
That deck right in front of
36 more vessels still wait for discovery. At journey's end, Ballard laid down a plaque to honor those who died in Iron Bottom Sound.
Thousands of feet deep in the ocean. Who's going to see it after all? Maybe this is the right place for it because this is their gravesite. This is where they died. This is where they'll always be.
Tacticians of the world were to leave it to survivors, you wouldn't have any wars. You wouldn't have any.
I just have a feeling Papa knows we're here.
Sitting here, and I look out there,
I can just picture those fellows out there. And as I'm telling my story here, they're just saying to me, I know they are. Tell it like it is, Bert. Really tell it like it is. So I'm trying my best, fella. That's why I came back here. Just to pay my respects to you fellas out there. You'll always be with me. You're in my mind. Think of the good times we had. I salute you. That's the way it is. I don't know what else I can tell you.
Next Saturday on 10's Documentary of the Week. Journey into a magnificent wilderness.
Have a look at this.
Cross dangerous mountains to discover a hidden river and surprising wildlife.
They're often mistaken for rough-scaled snakes or even called swamp tigers.
The danger of the unknown. From a deadly confrontation to the miracle of birth and the thrill of the rapids. Share an all-new adventure and the beauty of the hidden river next Saturday. Stay on 10 for a special two-hour edition of Intrigue and Suspense with Angela Lansbury and Murder, She Wrote. Monday night at 7.30 on Healthy, Wealthy and Wise, Ian Hewitson heads to Tassie to sample mussels. Ross Greenwood will show you how to save hundreds of dollars a year by shopping with your neighbours, and Jim Brown rediscovers the joys of cycling. Tuesday, a tribute to one of Australia's greatest singers.
Totally awesome talent.
Consummate performer.
Featuring rare archival footage and the songs that have made him a star. John Farnham, Australia's favourite son, on 10. A damning allegation has the city in turmoil.
The police raped my baby.
Now, will politics...
Don't allow her to be patched.
Stay out of it.
...push justice out of the way. Law and Order, 9.30 Tuesday on 10.
Good evening. Prime Minister Paul Keating has conceded one of his biggest critics in the Mabo debate may be right. After talks with WA Premier Richard Court today.
On Sports Tonight.
McDonald's McFeast is 100% Australian beef. Kraft cheese, Heinz ketchup, McCormick mustard, onions, lettuce, tomatoes, pickles on a buttercup bun. And when it's served with French fries from Bird's Eye and a Coca-Cola, all for $3.95, it's a McFeast extra value meal.
$3.95? That's incredible. It's back time.
To a night of musical magic. Nissan Infinity proudly presents Dame Kiri Kanawa in concert. Nissan Infinity proudly presents Dame Kiri Kanawa in concert.
Good evening.
It's a pleasure to welcome you to the State Theatre here at the Victorian Arts Centre in Melbourne for an evening of rare operatic pleasure indeed. We're here to enjoy a performance by the world's leading soprano, Dame Kiri to Kanawa, with the Australian Pops Orchestra conducted by John Hopkins. Dame Kiri has accomplished more than any other diva in bringing both grand opera and popular song to the widest possible audience. So it's fitting that among the highlights of tonight's concert, which begins in a moment, will be popular classical opera by Mozart and Puccini, as well as songs by Rodgers and Hammerstein, Bernstein and Lloyd Webber. Dame Kiri has become a familiar figure on every opera and concert stage in the world, but she's also renowned here and in New Zealand for her highly innovative and hugely popular outdoor concerts in recent years. And of course, there was the wedding of Prince Charles and Lady Diana Spencer, where Dame Kiri sang to an audience worldwide of more than 600 million people. So, on behalf of Channel 10, it's my pleasure to present to you, in concert, Dame Kiri to Kanawa.
Loud, I believe the angel trumpets blow. It's a bluebird.
Wow.
It's not.
Sure is. 2.4 16 valve double overhead cam. Really goes, huh, Dad?
Check this out. Speed and warning lights come up on the windscreen.
Yeah. Head-up display.
Darling, there's enough room for you to take all the girls to ballet.
Automatic climate control. Six-speaker sound system.
With 160 watt and diversity antenna.
And
look, it's got a CD player as well.
It hasn't.
It has!
The fully imported Bluebird from the new Nissan.
You know what this is? It's a dinosaur egg.
From Hungry Jack's comes an offer that's been 65 million years in the making.
You feel that?
A Whopper, regular fries, regular drink, and one of four different dinosaurs in its own egg.
Can I touch it?
Sure.
The Jurassic Park Dino Combo. For a limited time only.
Fresh for you and Hungry Jack's.
They're the world's hottest rock band, and you can be guests of the Sunday Herald Sun at U2's Melbourne concert with 10 double passes to be won. Plus, there's a free hair and skincare booklet by Dr. James Wright. And Australia in the next century. What will it really be like? Our exclusive report reveals the Australia our children will inherit.
Everyone's waking up to the Sunday Herald Sun.
There are a lot of colourful claims being made by light beers these days. So what's so special about Foster's Special?
Jobs in the year 2000. Will your children stand a chance?
The shape of work is changing.
The disappearing jobs, those that'll survive.
What people are getting are mixed or confusing messages.
An important guide, first at 5.
suspect that you know these songs, so I don't announce them.
Oh,
I'm sure you agree. Dame Kiri Te Kanawa in full voice is quite outstanding. We hope you're enjoying the program tonight. And coming up, a change of pace. We'll move into a selection of classics from Bizet's opera Carmen, and then on to the popular musicals, including West Side Story, Les Miserables, Song and Dance, and The Sound of Music. Supporting Dame Kiri tonight is the Australian Pops Orchestra, headed by world-renowned conductor John Hopkins, who's had a long association with Dame Kiri's magnificent career. The 80-member Australian Pops Orchestra continues to grow in stature, with concerts ranging from classical to musical. We'll take an interval now and return to tonight's recital shortly.
Next on Healthy, Wealthy and Wise, Lynn goes west to soak up the arty freedom of Fremantle.
Hey, I don't look like that.
I haven't finished yet.
Jim looks at family fun and fitness as the bicycle makes a big comeback. And Ross finds out how shopping in a co-op stacks up against a supermarket.
We beat them hands down every time.
Peter tests the latest in anti-car theft devices. And Ian gets to the bottom of mussel farming in Tasmania before cooking up
French classic Moules Marinier.
All on Healthy, Wealthy and Wise, Monday on 10.
You start out with the sauce, then the mozzarella cheese, add a little beef, then bacon, chicken, onion, and capsicum. You put them all together and you got yourself a real swinging combo. The 1090 Large Combo Express from Pizza Hut. For more toppings, more taste, and fast free delivery, dial 131-241.
Gorgeous hair is the best revenge.
Ultras is for women who demand the best.
This is for my mother, who said, Angela, can't you do anything better with your hair? This is for Phil, for thinking Nancy was better.
Ultras has a unique gel for the ultimate in color, shine, and condition.
This is for me, a redder, better me.
This is for you, honey.
You thought you'd be better off with a brunette?
Ultras from Clairol. Gorgeous hair is the best revenge.
Safe, secure nesting. Lean on MLC.
Dynamo Liquid with Grease Release removes the heart and shadow of the stain. A little on the stain and the rest in the wash. Beautiful. Dynamo Liquid with Grease Release, the answer to greasy stains.
If you're looking for a taste that's out of the ordinary, Strongbow White.
We'll be right back.
Listen Infinity trusts you're enjoying tonight's concert by Dame Kiri to Kanawa.
Jack's comes an offer that's been 65 million years in the making.
You feel that?
A Whopper, regular fries, regular drink, and one of four different dinosaurs in its own egg.
Can I touch it?
Sure.
The Jurassic Park Dino Combo. For a limited time only.
Fresh for you and Hungry Jack's.
Waking up.
the world's hottest rock band, and you can be guests of the Sunday Herald Sun at U2's Melbourne concert with 10 double passes to be won. Plus, there's a free hair and skincare booklet by Dr. James Wright. And Australia in the next century, what will it really be like? Our exclusive report reveals the Australia our children will inherit.
Everyone's waking up.
Support 50 charities this Christmas by buying cards and gifts for the people you love at the Combined Charities Christmas Shop, again in the basement of 203 Flinders Lane. Select from over 180 beautiful card designs and a wide range of gifts for home and overseas. A fast card over printing service is also available. The Combined Charities Christmas Shop in the basement of 203 Flinders Lane, behind St Paul's. Open till the week before Christmas, Monday to Friday, 8:45 to 5 p.m. and from mid-November on Saturdays, 9 to 1.
This is Harold. Harold is living proof of the importance of calcium in our diet. The condition of his bones is excellent. He knew we use up calcium every day, and that's where Physical is so good. It has nearly twice as much calcium as normal milk. So for healthy bones like Harold's, let's exercise and get Physical. Harold, you're a very naughty boy.
Next week on Hench.
We catch the bootleggers cashing in on Sydney's Olympics.
A minimum of $10,000 a day.
The million-dollar business that's ripping our athletes off.
You took the first letter as a joke. I'd like you to take this one seriously.
Oh, no, okay.
Do you have a license for printing these designs?
No.
And we go on tour with one of the world's supergroups, Bon Jovi. Behind the scenes with unlimited access. Hench, weeknight, 7 o'clock.
song that only we are hearing. I don't know what's going on, can't work it out at all. Whatever made you choose me,
Dad, what's that?
That is a bluebird.
Wow.
It's not.
Sure is. 2.4 16 valve double overhead cam. Really goes, huh, Dad?
Check this out. Speed and warning lights come up on the windscreen.
Yeah, head-up display.
Darling, there's enough room for you to take all the girls to ballet.
Automatic climate control. Six-speaker sound system.
With 160 watt and diversity antenna.
And?
Look, it's got a CD player as well.
It hasn't.
It has!
The fully imported Bluebird from a new Nissan.
Please, sir. I want some more.
More?
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 Please, sir. Potatoes and more.
New Potatoes and More from Maggi makes choice Tasmanian potatoes more tasty, more cheesy. In no more than 10 minutes, you couldn't ask for more.
Ask for more?
New Maggi Potatoes and More. They'll be back for more.
G'day, Sydney here. This week in every Sydney superstore, we're going to have a price wipeout. All floor stock will be sacrificed. No reasonable offer will be refused. Lounges from $2.99, $3.99, $5.99, $8.99. Even genuine leather. Hundreds of beds will be sacrificed at near cost. Like this queen-size set, only $2.99. And still pay only $10 deposit with 2 years to pay. Sydney lounges and bedding. Preston, Brooklyn, Bitcham, Springvale. Where the bargains continue 7 days a week.
When I first saw it, I thought, I'm not wearing that. I mean, Stay Free Prima just seemed too thin. How could this possibly protect better than a normal pad? Anyway, I tried it. And even on my heaviest days, when I usually wear the bulkiest pad, I felt nothing but protected.
Only Stay Free Prima has a highly absorbent natural core of sphagnum that draws away moisture for the best ultra-thin protection. Stay Free Prima.
You won't believe it until you try it.
Great beers don't just come out of the blue. It takes time. So what's so special about Foster's Special?
8:30 Tuesday. Spend a memorable hour with one of Australia's greatest singers,
Johnny Farnham,
featuring rare archival footage, all the songs that made him a star, and some rare insights.
I couldn't believe this guy's voice, you know. It was like religion hitting.
From Whispering Jack to Superstar and beyond.
He's an amazing guy.
A consummate performer.
The man, the music. 8:30 Tuesday, John Farnham, Australia's favourite son on 10.
To be
Allegation has the city in turmoil.
The police raped my baby.
Now will politics...
Don't allow her to be patched.
Stay out of it.
...push justice out of the way. Law and Order, 9:30 Tuesday on 10.
If you're looking for the taste of fruit and the goodness of fibre and oats, look no further than Kellogg's All Bran Fruit and Oats. Keeps you healthy on the inside.
I know exactly the car I want.
I'm really looking at a little hatchback, something.
Now the National introduces the tailored personal loan to help you own that car sooner and save you money.
For me, it'd be being independent as well.
And so we can tailor that loan specifically to suit your needs.
I really didn't think that a personal loan would be so flexible and quick.
And look how much interest you'd save.
Yeah.
So how would you feel about owning your car so soon?
Wonderful.
Ask the National to tailor a personal loan to your needs.
Now Sunbeam shows you how to turn last night's mince into magical savoury mince pies. Or leftover chicken into magical chicken and mushroom pies. New from Sunbeam, it's pie magic. Just think them up, you choose, from a can or the fridge. Fill them up, and 8 minutes later, two golden brown crispy pies. Tonight, it's fresh fruit pies. Sunbeam's new pie magic. Think them up, fill them up, bake them up. It's just magic.
Avec mes souvenirs.
Bonjour Pierre, ça va?
J'ai allumé le feu, mes chagrins, mes plaisirs.
Pierre, on casse ma
je repars à zéro. Non, rien de rien. Non, je ma vie, car mes joies aujourd'hui, ça commence avec moi.
With Nescafe, we've not only captured the soul of espresso, we've bottled it.
Hey, Dewey, I just discovered something you didn't tell me about Nappy San. Of course, all my whites now come up so white and bright. But I'm amazed how well it works on all kinds of things. The kids' sports gear, beach clothes. Hmm? No, they're not white. Colours. Yes, colours. Oh, Dewey, didn't you know?
Nappy San has always been wonderful on whites. The news is it's brilliant on washable colours too.
Jobs in the year 2000. Will your children stand a chance?
The shape of work is changing.
The disappearing jobs, those that'll survive.
What people are getting are mixed or confusing messages.
An important guide, first at five.
Thank you. should love the must be something that the angels don't plan. The chimney smoking, the roof is leaking in, but he don't seem to care. He can be happy with just him when his kiss has got gin. Fish got a swim, birds got a fly. I've got to love one man till I die. Can't help loving that man of mine.
Yeah.
Good evening. Just ahead in 10 Eyewitness News, the federal government and WA still deadlocked over Mabo as Premier Richard Court holds his ground in talks with Paul Keating. A Victorian town on flood alert, but emergency measures may do more harm than good. Elopement or foul play, police probe the mystery disappearance of a young couple. And disappointment for Michael Jackson fans, the pop star cancels his Australian tour. All the day's news from here and overseas coming up at 10:55, 10 Eyewitness News.
Next week on Hinch, we catch the bootleggers cashing in on Sydney's Olympics. The million-dollar business that's ripping our athletes off. And we go on tour with one of the world's supergroups, Bon Jovi. Hinch, weeknight, 7 o'clock.
Darkest moments, and he was there.
The only active agent who ever lost a president.
30 years later,
you really have the guts to take a bullet, Frank?
The hell is this?
He's back.
This guy's gonna make a try. I gotta be there.
In the line of fire.
I see you standing over the grave of another dead president.
Clint Eastwood.
That's not gonna happen.
In the line of fire.
When I first saw it, I thought, I'm not wearing that. I mean, Stay Free Prima just seemed too thin. How could this possibly protect better than a normal pad? Anyway, I tried it. And even on my heaviest days, when I usually wear the bulkiest pad, I felt nothing but protected.
Only Stay Free Prima has a highly absorbent natural core of sphagnum that draws away moisture for the best ultra-thin protection. Stay Free Prima.
You won't believe it until you try it.
If there's one thing
we all know about, it's gold. So when Golden Valley decided to call their new full-flavoured fruit gold, they asked our expert opinion. Well, what is our expert opinion?
Gold.
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 Totally awesome.
It's official. New Golden Valley Gold, with no added sugar, is so full-flavoured, it's awesome.
If there's one thing Target have learned about kids, it's that you can't stop them being kids. All we can do is make our clothes tougher than the kids. So no matter what your kids do to them, Target Quality Control guarantees they'll live to fight another day. Target's kids' clothes. No matter how tough your kids are, wear tougher.
Je suis dans le
Well, this has certainly been an evening to remember. Dame Kiri is a truly incomparable performer. And from here in her dressing room, the accolades and the flowers are rolling in from admirers and well-wishers, literally filling the room. I hope you've enjoyed tonight's performance as much as I have. It's certainly been a privilege to be part of such a wonderful occasion. So we say goodnight to you for now with a final encore on stage from Dame Kiri to Kanawa.
Eyewitness News is next on 10 Then Sports Tonight. On the eve of the release of his new album, Then Again, John Farnham is paid a special tribute by his peers in the industry. John Farnham, Australia's favourite son, hosted by Bert Newton, Tuesday night, 8:30, here on 10. Dame Kiri to Kanawa in concert was proudly brought to you by Nissan Infiniti.
If you want two of the hottest shows on television, then 10 Sundays are for you. At 6:30, when modern-day pirates strike, the lieutenant wants in on the action.
I could use one of his yachts and set up a sting.
But just how close?
How are you enjoying your honeymoon so far?
Will she get on Baywatch? Then at 7:30, they're taking a couple of days off, leaving Beverly Hills behind and taking on the wilderness.
Are we having fun yet?
It's going to be a wild weekend.
Remember, guys, we're on vacation.
90210 after Baywatch, Sunday on 10.
Tonight's edition of Eyewitness News is proudly brought to you by the fully imported Bluebird from the new Nissan.
This is 10 Eyewitness News with Juanita Phillips.
No Mabo joy in a meeting between the Prime Minister and the West Australian Premier.
I think it would be fair to say that no one gave any ground.
The waiting game. A Victorian town faces its worst flood in a century. A jockey dies in a Sydney race fall.
Twig has broken down. Twig or two down. Twig looked to break down.
And the news that stunned Michael Jackson fans and promoters.
Unfortunately, the Michael Jackson concert dates scheduled for Australia will not occur.
And that's it.
Good evening. More Mabo headaches for Prime Minister Keating tonight. He's still no closer to a national solution on native land title after the failure of talks in Perth with WA Premier Richard Court.
The two leaders have been sparring for months over the best way to deal with the fallout of the High Court recognition of native land title. Mr. Keating has reported success with other states. Mr. Court says WA has a bigger, different problem.
Well, the trees vibrate when now right me. And I think of all the love we have been making. You touched my head.
I think Sam Cooke is the greatest singer who ever lived, and I think that John Farnham is the greatest singer alive.
Tree too proud to bear. One man to stop the trouble. One kiss to seal your fate. One kid that needs some action. One link in a chain reaction. I've got a fever in my soul. No, I wanna die before I get old. It took some time just to bring me. One drop from a poison bed. One fruit too small to bear. One tree too proud to bear. One man to stop the trouble. One kiss to seal your fate. One kid that needs some action. One link in a chain reaction.
It's interesting to chart John Farnham's progression as a songwriter. Because remember, he came from a musical area where, unlike rock, which was influenced by the Lennon-McCartney example, you didn't write your own songs. In the musical area John Farnham was in, you got a songwriter to write the song, an arranger to arranger, and a producer to produce it, and you were the voice. And so, you know, he came out of that period not really adept at you know, sort of getting down with the guitar or the piano and actually creating rock songs. But I think that once he realized that he could do it, once he actually got a feeling for writing rock songs, he became a fairly interesting and intuitive writer. And, you know, there were sort of examples here, one or two, you know, sort of, you know, his work on Playing to Win. But then when it got to sort of a very pivotal point in his career after the Age of Reason album, where he had to make a third blockbuster album and the pressure was on, and everyone expected him to do what he'd done in the first two, that is, to get the best songs that publishers were offering him. He actually sat down and did a lot of the writing himself, which was a remarkably brave thing to do. And the songs were... You know, the songs were very, very good. The album, in fact, outsold the one before it. Chain Reaction sold more copies than Age of Reason. And I think that to a man who probably didn't need, necessarily, credibility, it really did bring him that. It bought him a great deal of credibility. Now, the voice, the great singer, the man whose, you know, vocal talents had never, ever been doubted, showed that he could actually write songs of a very, very high level.
Got myself into some trouble tonight. Guess I'm just feeling blue. It's been so long since I've seen your face. This distance between me and you. That voice you showed me is not the one that I know. I must be strung out on what I do. Don't hang up again. There's nothing else I know how to do. But I burn for you. What am I gonna do? Burn for you.
He can sing any style of music. I mean, you take this guy, John Farnham, and give him a rock and roll song, he's amazing. You give him a ballad, you're gonna die. You give him an R&B song, he's gonna riff it like no R&B singer's business. And it's amazing. I mean, the guy is a chameleon.
Something is wrong with my baby. You know that something is wrong. She's a worry. Oh, how to feel that same old misery.
Come from sort of different backgrounds. He wasn't as an R&B background as me, I guess, you know, or as Memphis-y background as me. I sent him a song and he loved it and came up to my place and a couple of cigars, a couple of cognacs later, we were down and happening. You know, it was great. You know, it was quite a funny little experience, really, because we were both very wary of each other. We both had major success in this country, you know, particularly over the last couple of years. You know, John with the, you know, Chain Reaction and whatnot, you know, and it was just, you know, you're the voice and all that. And I was thinking, geez, this guy's a, you know, great singer. And I was actually very nervous about singing with him. And I believe I found out later, so was he. But we just got down there and literally, you know, it took, you know, no time at all. We locked in straight away and it was fabulous, you know, it was great singing.
Something's wrong with me.
This is Sizzling Sex.
You can actually interact with another person,
and you can make love to the other person.
Black Label Games.
The safest sex around.
Red Hot Fantasies become virtual reality.
Is this going to be the sex of the future?
Donahue, Love Games of the 90s.
We got ultrasound of people making love.
Go inside the computer for a sexual revolution.
Nice.
Donahue, Love Games of the 90s. Next Tuesday.
Wouldn't you kill for hair that's shiny and healthy?
Constant perming and brushing gave me split ends.
But Pantene's new treatment conditioners have proven...
John, apart from his career in rock and roll, has worked in theatre, and so he's pretty au fait with the different sort of demands and things that are made on you in a kind of theatrical situation. But this is a cross between the two. This is half rock and roll concert, half theatre. And, you know, John's, you know, been on a bridge across those two things for many years, so, you know, he's a natural. Mm. He's an amazing guy, you know, what can I say? He's just a great singer. He's one of the original... kept his head, knows exactly what he's doing, can hang loose and have a good time and still come up with the goods. It's pretty rare, you know. People like him don't grow on trees.
Well, can you see the lighting rig? You got a shot of that? It looks like the USS Enterprise. And almost, I tell you what, the first couple of rehearsals, it really was. Beam me up, Scotty, no sign of intelligent life.
He's such a charismatic person. Much more, actually, than I ever imagined, because working with him, you get a sense of his discipline and his vocal capacity, which is just incredible. Like, he can sing for hours on end and hit all of these notes. And his, you know, the songs are really demanding and they require quite a lot of emotional impact, you know. And he's so generous and he receives everybody. Every single person in the cast has had at some stage through its rehearsals or its performance an interaction with him that's personal and intimate. And he means it, you know, like he just doesn't... He has no ego. He's completely a pro, a consummate performer.
I think if John wasn't the kind of guy he is, then it could possibly be really awe-inspiring. But he's so down to earth and so sort of warm that he doesn't sort of make you, he makes you feel comfortable immediately. So you sort of have this sort of friend thing happening.
He's very generous to other people that he works with, especially the cast and things like that. He would always make sure that they get their accolades, you know, and their applause and their recognition. And he genuinely, when you're singing, you can see him listening to what you're singing. And if you're really going for it and really putting in, he really gets off on it.
We went to this restaurant, a Japanese restaurant, at about 7 o'clock, drank sake for hours. And then, you know, next thing you know, John's half naked in the restaurant. This is 3 a.m. or something, you know, and they're trying to get rid of us. And he's one more drink, you know. So, like, this whole reputation that John's got as being Mr. Nice and Mr. Mild, you know, I'm sure he's a nice guy, but the guy's a bloody maniac. And don't let anybody ever tell you any different.
Mistake number one.
We don't want guys like you in this town.
Mistake number two.
You picked up.
Okay, if I call you Leland?
Yeah, we were nervous.
Yeah, it helps a little, but I've known a lot of the actors on the show for a long time, Michael Tucker and Jill Eikenberry and John Spencer, but still, there was that. It was exactly like that, going to a new junior high school.
They were all eyeballing us, checking out what we brought to
it. Oh, yeah, the first scene we did, they were all kind of standing around watching, you know.
But they're supportive, and, you know, so.
Yeah, great group of people.
Yeah.
And one other new lawyer should stir up debate around the conference table on L.A. law this season. The character is a fundamentalist Christian and a conservative. The season starter of L.A. law is tomorrow night on NBC.
Susan Rutan cleaned out her desk at L.A. law after last season, but now she's back at work on a new miniseries, Jack Reed, an Honest Cop. On the set, she's occupied with her own Jack, and he's an 18-pounder.
You okay, Jack?
Yeah, but...
Lydia Travis?
You should be the detective.
Susan Rattan and Brian Dennehy star in the miniseries. Dennehy's the tough cop who's a soft touch with his family. Susan plays Arlene, a woman who always makes the best of being a cop's wife.
There's a speech in this movie where Arlene speaks about trying to maintain today, that you just are grateful for the time you have today, and if you ever start thinking about what might happen, it's a waste.
Susan says that's a philosophy she likes to live by once the cameras stop rolling. A new single mom, she recently adopted Jackson, whom she takes with her to work. She's been at her son's side from the very moment he was born.
I was the coach, I was a cheerleader, I got to catch him. It was fun. It was.
Susan says there's never a shortage of babysitters on the set. Even Brian enjoys getting in on the act every once in a while.
So gorgeous. Being healthy boy.
Yeah. It's the one thing that's great here. There's never a problem about, you know, child care. Everybody's willing to volunteer to hold him or to talk to him or something.
Ironically, Susan's babysitting co-star, Brian Dennehy, recently adopted a child as well. He told us he just wanted a high school graduation to go to when he's 72. Jack Reed, An Honest Cop, will air later this season on NBC.
Robin Williams is working in a television series for the first time since Mork and Mindy. He'll appear in an upcoming episode of NBC's Homicide: Life on the Street. The co-executive producer of Homicide is Williams' friend, Barry Levinson. And CBS has canceled its Thursday night series, Angel Falls, after only 6 episodes. A replacement series has not yet been named.
After 2 episodes of the controversial series NYPD Blue, the ABC station in Lexington, Kentucky, put the debate over the series to the viewers, and they voted to pull the plug. More than 38,000 people responded to an informal telephone poll. 58% said the show should not continue to run. 42% wanted it to stay.
Next on E.T., the grand diva of soul meets the Phantom of the Opera.
Sunday, Our World's Around Australia adventure continues with Malcolm Douglas.
A huge coral reef.
A journey of discovery, spectacular sights and precious rewards.
Gleaming gold nuggets.
An Our World premiere series, Sunday, 6:30 on 9.
Introducing the new Mazda MPV. Room for 7. ABS braking. Great all-round vision. 3-litre V6. The new Mazda MPV multi-purpose vehicle. In a word, it's versatile.
Kitchens, 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 Nobby Kitchens Factory Direct sale is on now.
That's right, John. Quality square-edge kitchens, only $2,300. These quality kitchens with rolled-edge doors, only $3,700. Now that's a bargain. Nobby, Australia's largest kitchen manufacturer. Kitchens are water-resistant and come with a 5-year written warranty. $5,400 for oven-baked solid timber doors, unbeatable value.
Nobby Kitchens Factory Direct sale is on all this weekend at 96 Hoddle Street, Collingwood, and 344 Ferntree Gully Road, Mount Waverley.
These days we're more sensitive to our body's needs. I want a really effective antiperspirant deodorant that's gentle to my skin. Rexona Hypoallergenic Roll-On is alcohol-free, so it doesn't sting, even after shaving. Its gentle, effective formula gives me long-lasting confidence. It's the one step in my routine I never forget. New Rexona Hypoallergenic. It won't let you down.
For complete care of your car, you can't go past an ultra-tuned service centre. Fixed prices, no surprises, guaranteed. You can't go past ultra-tune.
These days, every dollar you save counts. And right now, with savings like these on premium 4-litre interior paints, look at the difference Bristol could make this spring. But hurry, this special spring offer won't last.
On A Current Affair.
We are very excited about it.
The revolutionary swimsuits that let you tan.
It's extremely light.
As if you weren't wearing anything.
I would like to see each Australian wearing one.
But is it good for the body?
A tan is a sign of skin damage.
Tonight, 6:30.
Darkness.
caress of the music of the night. Close your eyes, start a journey through a strange new world. Leave all thoughts on...
Okay, with your hand upon my heart, take one.
At a recording studio in Los Angeles, Michael Crawford of Phantom of the Opera fame has been putting down the final tracks of his new album. In a surprise vocal pairing, Patti LaBelle joins Crawford on a duet called With Your Hand Upon My Heart.
I'm a simple man. You know I don't have much of a plan. All the crazy things I put us through.
Both agree they hit it off right from the moment they walked in for the first session.
Feels so good, Michael.
Oh, it does feel
so pretty.
I feel your head upon.
You know what? We get to, when we say upon your and my heart. It's
yes.
Like my and your.
However, Michael likes to kid Patti about crossing over from gospel, rhythm and blues to Crawford's mellower love songs.
When we met, she thought I was Ben Vereen.
He's
That's
lying.
Why.
He is lying.
So she wouldn't be here. The only reason I got her is because I'm singing another guy's a Ben Vereen. So, Ben, forgive me for this one.
With your hand on my heart, you make me stronger than I thought I could be.
The two also discovered a unique vocal chemistry.
Our voices are naturally meant to be together. We have this nice sound together, and it's like you don't have to pretend with, I don't have to pretend, and he doesn't have to pretend with me. It just happens. When we open our mouths, the sound comes out, and it comes out kind of cute.
I feel your hand upon my heart.
Michael and Patti also put together a video of the song that required a little acting for the cameras. Patti says seeing them perform the song as a racially mixed couple gives it even greater impact.
We knew that when we did this love song, and I guess you would say too, a black woman and a white man doing a love song together, most people would think, well, gosh, why? It's because this love song is universal, and it's for all people, and we feel like all people. I feel like just a woman singing with a man, and that's the bottom line.
Yep. Thank you.
Really
bless
nice.
Your heart. Thank you.
Michael Crawford and Barbara Streisand also do a duet on this album. They sing the song that helped make him famous, Music of the Night, from Phantom of the Opera. The album is in stores right now. Great Moments in American Sports History features the perfect form of Yankee pitcher Don Larsen's perfect game in the 1956 World Series, plus baseball great Mickey Mantle and the U.S. hockey team's 1980 Olympic victory over the USSR. There's also pioneering television coverage of the National Football League.
The first overtime game in NFL history pitted the glamorous and favored New York Giants of Alex Webster, Frank Gifford, and Sam Huff against coach Weeb Eubank and his jittery team of Baltimore Colts.
The other video is called Championship Moments and concentrates on heroes like race car champ Richard Petty and a young basketball star.
Here comes the 20-year-old rookie down the middle. Dawkins went to him and scored and sent him to the line. There it is. It's over, and the most valuable player is Magic Johnson.
Magic Johnson excelled in one arena, and quarterback Doug Williams dominated another. In Super Bowl 22, this Washington Redskin demonstrated an unsurpassed passing game against Denver.
I think for me going to the Super Bowl and getting the opportunity to play is some of the dream that Martin Luther King is talking about. Not so much black and white, but the fact as an individual, as a person, and no matter who you are,